Mall giants here in the Philippines gearing up for the implementation of voluntary face mask use indoors. Ayala Malls and SM Supermalls say they are ready to implement the new rule once official guidelines are laid out, but both still encourage the public to continue following minimum health protocols.
Ang ating DOH ay meron naman mga numbers na nagsasabi na mataas ang vaccination rate sa ating mga kababayan. So, yes, it's fairly safe, but we still encourage, of course, our customers, our mga tao na pupunta sa loob ng malls to follow pa rin ang ating protocols, no? Yun pa rin ang social distancing, tsaka pati mga personal hygiene.
We will always support the government or the president in whatever decision they will make. Well, the people right now has gotten used to wearing face masks naman na, so I don't really think naman that it will make a lot of difference.
For Go Negosyo founder Joey Concepcion, government should let private companies come up with their own mask rule.
Give the decision to the company, no? They should make that decision. If they still would like to insist that the employees wear face masks, then I guess they have reasons. The only suggestion that I would request is that maybe exclude public transportation like buses and MRTs, no? That's still being followed around the world. But restaurants, you know, indoor spaces that are not compressed and, you know, it's everything is normal all over the world.
Meanwhile, foreigners unvaccinated for COVID-19 also set to be allowed entry into the country by the Philippine government. The tourism department says travelers without the jabs will only need a negative antigen test 24 hours prior to departure to Manila. They can also take the test upon arriving in the Philippines. Now, the agency has yet to say when this will take effect. The government only previously allowed fully vaccinated tourists into the country. The tourism secretary assures Filipinos curbing the pandemic remains a priority despite the easing of restrictions.
We simply cannot go on in a pandemic perspective because we have to give our country an opportunity to thrive. While maintaining basic health protocols on one hand and safeguarding and protecting livelihood and the economy on the other.
The World Health Organization chief, Tedros Ghebreyesus, placed a courtesy call on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in Malacañang. Now, the palace says the two discussed how the Philippines is moving forward post-pandemic, with Marcos emphasizing the need to find a balance between the economy and people's safety. Ghebreyesus is in Manila to attend the WHO Western Pacific Regional Committee meeting this week. Let's now get an update on the magnitude 6.4 quake that rocked Abra and nearby provinces. We have on the line Fivox OIC, Dr. Toto Bacoycol. Good morning, Dr. Toto. What more can you tell us about the earthquake in Abra?
Yes, good morning po. Last night there was this magnitude 6.4 earthquake. The epicenter was located at 9 kilometers north, 33 west of Lagayan, Abra. And as of now, we have recorded, as of 6 a.m., we have recorded 368 aftershocks. The biggest aftershock is 4.8. And the maximum intensity that was recorded last night was intensity 6. And it was felt at La Paz, Abra.
Any other areas in Abra that were adversely affected?
Merong mga karatig barangay that karatig provincia that where the earthquake was felt in of course in Ocos Sur, La Union, in Pampanga, in Cagayan. It was also felt in Isabela.
And Dr. Toto, how long should we be monitoring Tacuba for further aftershocks?
Usually the aftershocks would dwindle after time, so probably several weeks. We can see we could see na mag-lowering number of the aftershocks that are recorded.
All right. Thank you so much for that quick call. You stay safe, Dr. Toto.